Welcome back to BOGObiology. This is 5-Minute Bio, where we discuss a key scientific concept in 5 minutes or less. Today's topic is the cell cycle. Today we're going to ask ourselves the questions, what is the cell cycle? What is its purpose? What happens in each phase? And also, what happens when it goes wrong? The cell cycle is a sequence of events in the life of a cell, beginning with its creation from another cell and ending when it divides. The cell cycle occurs in order to replace old cells and also to allow for the growth and development of the organism. Eukaryotic cells have two major phases, interphase and mitosis. In interphase, the cell grows and it also duplicates its genetic material. In mitosis, it divides and forms two new cells called daughter cells. Before we go any further, notice that the cell spends the vast majority of its lifespan in interphase, not in mitosis. Also notice that both interphase and mitosis are split up into multiple sections. To help us keep the different phases organized, I created this chart, and you may want to do the same. Before we get started, see if you can figure out what each of these colorful boxes corresponds to. And for now, ignore this one right here. We're going to come back to it. Hopefully you labeled your chart something like this. We're going to start with the G1 phase. During the G1 or Gap1 portion of interphase, the cell grows and it also creates mRNA and protein. Before moving on to the S phase, however, the cell will undergo something called the G1S checkpoint. The cell checks to make sure that all of the procedures have been completed correctly. If they have, the cell will move on to the S phase. If the cell detects insufficient growth or errors in its genetic material, it will likely enter what's called the G0 phase instead. A damaged cell would therefore no longer be able to continue dividing. Certain types of cells will also purposely enter the G0 phase. Two examples are neurons and muscle cells, which don't continuously divide the way that most cells do. Once they have grown to their full size, they will live out the rest of their lives in G0. Most cells will proceed to the S phase, where they will continue to grow and then also will copy over their DNA. The synthesis that occurs during the S phase is actually where this phase gets its title from. The last of the three parts of interphase is called G2. Here the cell will continue to grow and it will also create a few organelles that it needs in order to divide. Before proceeding to mitosis and actually dividing, the cell goes through yet another checkpoint. The DNA is scanned for damage one final time. The cell will attempt to repair any damaged areas of DNA before proceeding to mitosis. We have now entered the M phase of the cell cycle. In prophase, the genetic material begins to condense. During metaphase, the chromosomes of genetic material align on the metaphase plate. Spindle fibers attach to each one and prepare to pull the genetic material to opposite poles. It is absolutely essential that the spindle fibers correctly attach to each pair of chromatids. Once in anaphase, the sister chromatids begin to be pulled towards opposite sets of poles. In telophase, cytokinesis occurs. The cell splits into two new cells. The process can then begin all over again. We now need to ask ourselves the unpleasant question of what happens when this goes wrong. Usually the series of checkpoints is excellent at preventing mistakes from happening during cell division, but occasionally mistakes are still made. We're going to look at two types of common errors, and both of them have to do with a malfunction of one of the checkpoints. If an error occurs at the G1 checkpoint, it often results in increased cell division. When damaged, unhealthy cells divide far too rapidly, we call it cancer. If an error occurs at the M checkpoint rather than the G1 checkpoint, it results in aneuploidy. Let's imagine that the attachment of the spindle fibers during this step here didn't go correctly, and thus we wound up with too many chromosomes on the right-hand side of the cell during anaphase. This would lead to both daughter cells having an incorrect number of chromosomes. This is what causes trisomy 21, also known as Down syndrome. Okay, that's it for today. If you found this video useful, I hope you'll let me know by hitting the like button or leaving me a comment down below. As always, please remember to cite your sources. I've listed the ones that I used to make this video below, and you can also find a ready-made APA citation for this video in the video description. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.